Before lunch, I ask you to get together on the stairs. It will be a wonderful group picture. Thank you. Sorry.
Ia microfonul.
Thank you very much. Hai, hai,
fie. Ia-l și pe la casă să-l dă. Să-l pornește, aprinde butonul.
Hello? You hear me? Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great pleasure for me to be here to present few issues about our institute. I am Florin Zgură, director of the Institute of Space Science from Bucharest. What is ISS? ISS, it's Institute of Space Science. It's a legal subsidiary of the National Institute for Laser Plasma and Radiation Physics in what is ISS history? I try to present you a few periods. Our institute first period is from 1956 up to 1977 as a cosmic ray laboratory in the frame of Institute of Atomic Physics. After that, as a center of astronomy and space sciences, the third period was Institute for Gravitation and Space Science in 1990. The strategy involvement in a big international projects was a good opportunity for Institute to open a new collaboration. The last item, it's started in 1996 up to present, it's Institute of Space Science, a subsidiary of the National Institute for Laser Plasma and Radiation. What is the ISS structure? Our institute is divided in six laboratories. One of them is high energy astrophysics and advanced technologies. The second one, cosmology and astroparticle physics, theoretical physics, space, plasma and magnetometry group, application of space and communication technology for society, and last but not the least, gravity, microgravity and nanosatellites. About topics for each one laboratories. Theoretical physics laboratory has topics atomic and molecular processes, kinetic theory of complex systems, exactly solvable models, space-time structures and symmetries in general relativity. For the cosmology and astroparticle physics, the topics our early universe, cosmic microwave background, dark matter, dark energy, modified gravity. Few issues about ESA space missions, Planck mission, Euclid mission, and core. Neutrino astronomy, Antares, and kilometer cap net, and the gamma ray astronomy. Development of neutrino telescopes, galactic physics, black holes, neutrino astrophysics, and cosmic rays, exotic particles. The laboratory high energy astrophysics and advanced technologies. Topics are Large Hadron Collider, high energy physics, quantum chromodynamics, quark gluon plasma, heavy ions, relativistic heavy ion collision, quarks deconfinement, quark gluon plasma production, phase transition. Other one, it's nuclear experiment and few bodies, system, relativistic reactive beam, astrophysics, high energy astrophysical phenomena, cosmic ray observatory, and grid computing, high performance computing, GPU computing, clustering and embedded system. Space plasma and magnetometric group, they have topics like solar terrestrial interactions, fundamental processes and collisionless plasma disturbance in geospace and connection with the Earth, and hardware development and software tools. The application of space and communication technology for society laboratory has topics spatial and communicational technologies applications in the society benefit, ground mobile telemedicine application with satellite communication covering the diagnostic and curative dimension and support in crisis situation. Application aiming counter measurements at the advanced effect of space environment due to microgravitation, and data mining application for satellite image time series analysis, aiming detection and characterization of evolution. And the last laboratory, gravity, microgravity, and nanosatellites, the topics gravity and their orbits, nanosatellites, space weather, and Earth observation. What is the ISS strategic goals? I will try to present you just a few one objective is involving in ground-based experiments of national and international interest with direction neutrino astrophysics, multi-messenger astronomy with neutrinos, gamma, and ultra-high energy cosmic rays, related participation in Antares kilometer CubeNet Warm and Pierre Auger Observatory, research of exotic particles and phenomena in cosmic rays and collider and accelerator beams participation in Antares kilometer CubeNet LAC CERN ALICE Moerdal CERN NUSTAR FAIR GSI NICA Joint Research Institute Dumna from Nucleotron, also innovative particle detection technique in application to large scale ground based experiment, for example FCAR collaboration, search for astronomical and astrophysical signature of weak equivalence principle violation, and the objective two, involvement in space, satellite space mission of international interest. This is also investigation of solar system, plasmas and satellite observation, participation to ESA scientific mission for the research of dark matter, dark energy and modified gravity. Objective for the to research on the International Space Station also have this is objective for the development of space science technology facilities like development of satellite instrumentation, development of integration of micro satellites for space applications. Goliat is first Romanian satellites. Also, development of competitive integrated satellite ground testing facility, the development of the competitive satellite missions and the communication center, and so on. Also, other objective is development and improvement of a strong computational and theoretical infrastructure to support the strategic plan objective like development of large-scale high-performance computing for high-energy physics, space sciences, astrophysics, and applications. And integration, other objective, integration of the ISS activities in national and international space applications of social and strategic interest with the possibility to technological transfer to public, private, and strategic partners, like disaster management, mobile in field, satellite communication, telemedicine for critical situation response, weather, space weather, remote sensing, counter measures for human space flight and adverse conditions. And now I will try to present you a few international collaboration, especially through European Space Agency project. Have some mission like participation in some mission like a cluster from ESA, Planck, Euclid, and so on. Also, we are involving in the big European facility like ALICE at CERN, Geneva, R3B, FAIR GSI, Becquerel at Dumna, Moredal at CERN, MPD at NICA, Dumna, FCAL at International Linear Collider. Participation in European projects, Antares, Kilometer 3, NET, participation in many cost projects from European Union. Also, a project Balkan, Black Sea, and Carpathian Sea Regional Network of Space Studies, Space Weather Studies. Also, on ground experiments. It's very important. Heavy iron experiments in nuclear emulsion, Becquerel. One experiment. Other one. It's ALICE at CERN, FAIR, GSI, SLIM, search for light monopoles from Bolivia, Antares, Kilometer Cub Net. Moredal at CERN, Pierre Roger Observatory, International Linear Collider. Also, we participate in European Space Agency through Cosmic Vision in a Euclid mission where part in this very prestigious mission. What about ISS outreach? How we achieve performance, we participate in many places to many exhibitions to present some results to public, to child. Also, we have some promotion of the ISS activities on TV news, the production, we have some production by our institute, have team. Few words about our HR management, human resources management. Our institute has a good policy according with the international policy in human resources. We try to follow the very important step: requirement, selection, placement, training, and development, the personal and evaluation. This is a very important point. This is a map of our training every year. The our colleagues will follow some trainings. The scientist is too important to have training about the project management, because our activity is supported by our authorities through the competition, and we make some proposal, and the proposal should be in a good project management schema. And here we have some plots about research personnel, young and dedicated. The average age is 40 years. This is distribution the personnel highly acknowledged. This is non PhD, PhD candidates, and PhD. This is gender distribution. Gender distribution from the previous plot. And this is highly experienced. This is the scientific title in Romania. This is the beginner, the junior, and the senior. This is the distribution. And also the gender distribution of the titles. What about the ISS funds? Our funds will our funds are from the our authorities only through competition. This is the crisis period. Decrease the purple, it's national funds decrease. A few words about our visibility. This is international visibility of our institute. This is number of days for each countries. What about ISS results? You can see here a few plots. This is the crisis period when the international conferences expanded, what's cut. And you can see also the ISS paper production increase. Why? Why we cut the money for the participation on the conferences? Because our risk management decide to put the money only to the salary, to keep the envelope of the personnel. I don't know if you see on the back. This is a quality research high citation paper. About ISS technology development, we have under construction a new building with data on basement, data center, clean room and utilities, first floor electronic lab, and second and third floors, offices, and the technological also roof, telescopes, satellites, antenna, and space science experiments. This building, I hope, will be finished next year. About our managerial tool, we are using a modern solution of enterprise resource planning, named EMSIS, Enterprise Management System. This platform has a few components: human resources and payroll, financial, logistics, business intelligence, and project management. A few features. This is on an Oracle database. Work with Java WebStar guy, and it is a cross platform. And this is some details about HR and payroll, financial module, logistic, and business intelligence. This is very, very interesting because we are in process to implement this one, because interesting to have good analysis what is the progress of our financial transactions. Also, as operational procedures, our institute has a certificate ISO 9001 quality management system, and where we are starting to obtain the informational security management system and the environmental management system. Thank you very much. Yes. Yes. We are an institute around 100 scientists, 120 with administrative staff, but around 100 scientists. At the answer for the second question, we have four or five projects in FP7. But our field is especially for space, and for people's Marie Curie or so on, and also for cost, the cost. Cost program in FP7. In Romania, also, it's difficult to have many projects in FP7 because the bureaucracy and the procedure is too difficult. Yes, it's very complicated.
Thank you. Welcome. Other questions? Okay, thank you, Sorin.
Cool.
Just a moment.
The board microphone should be. Ну, кажется, это работает. Is it okay? Я должен это держать, да? Ага. Okay. I slightly changed the title of my presentation since Maria gifted me so much time. So
I
allowed me to do this. And
In principle, I present our collaboration, and Institute for Space Science is part of this collaboration. We call this Little Big Project, Bigger Project, and it has under great name is there is acronym Beryllium Clustering Quest and Relativistic Multifragmentation, and in principle you can reach our website. And we work, we continue tradition of application of emulsion, nuclear track emulsion, which was established by our prominent scientist Vladimir Wechsler, who invented simultaneously with Edwin Macmillan principle of phase stability. He was founder in Soviet Union of cosmic ray researchers, in one of founders. And Alexander Baldin launched researches with relativistic nuclei, and this gave us a new breath in sense of emulsion application. So this was period of 50s, and in, so we are working in joint institute of nuclear research for nuclear research research, and Romania is one of founder countries in this institute, and countries which pay in budget, and we support it in very much in this respect. Рукой, да? Ага. Not to miss. Ага. Ага. Ну, не туда пошел, я понял. Так, дальше так. Ага. Why do we like nuclear track emulsion? If you take a photograph from microscope of nuclear interaction of relativistic nucleus and superimpose human hair, you can state that you have maybe best projection of real event which is happening in a micro world scale. So you can compare scales, and we make sort of projection, and still in fragmentation cone, in fragmentation cone of this relativistic nucleus, nuclear track emulsion stays unbeatable. In spirit of this meeting, I think I found I like very much Indian saying. I got it from Euronews in Russian, but in make translation in Google Translator, and no changes. So if you do not know where to go, look back and look at where you came from. So let's trace from where we are. So Becquerel is a famous name, and Becquerel, Henri Becquerel, discovered radioactivity. What is not, and he used it place of a company Lumiere Brothers. And Lumiere Brothers, and since that time we use silver bromine crystals, and this is something which is not changed in time. So ability of the of darkening of silver or bromine crystals is known since of 19th century. So Henri Becquerel applied electromagnet, and it was possible to see Maltian cross for him, and Becquerel rays appeared to be sensitive to magnetic fields. In such a way, radioactivity. And in the same way, Becquerel invented a photographic method of ionization detection, of a photographic technique of ionization detection. So next step, of course, this is epoch of Fowler-Perkins. We call this book Emulsion Bible, and still images of this textbook is incredible in quality, and still you can use this if you want to play with Photoshop to present students, and we have on our website even PDF stolen copy of PDF file, and you can use this when you make your professor work. But still, this physics of fragmentation of calcium is still is not accessible for electronic experiments. But emulsion sees this very perfectly, and acceleration for a cosmic ray physicist gifted me already this lady Passet, Galina Orlova. She gifted me old photographic plate of this event found in cosmic rays. So emulsion, you can see fragmentation cone is incredibly, in fragmentation cone emulsions are incredibly good, and you see such a many body physics that really inspiring you. Так. Ага. So, what about time goes, and since early 70s, Dubna accelerated neutrons, alpha particles, carbon on old machine created by under guidance of professor academician Wechsler on old synchrophazotron, and this was a source of researches with nuclear track in Malshan and distribution of Malshan among member countries, India, China, and so on. And new machine was created with the time, nucleotron, superconductive machine, and we used it opportunity to obtain few GeV nuclei to make formation of secondary beams of radioactive nuclei. Beryllium 9 is not radioactive nucleus, but it is toxic, and it has to be secondary one. So in fragmentation of boron-10, it was possible to make boron-8 in charge exchange lithium-7, beryllium-7, and we can idea of our project was to continue tradition of exposure with stable nuclei, but extend it to radioactive nuclei. And in principle, there are arguments beyond this. We know about limiting fragmentation of nuclei. We know that it is reaction in case of diffractive dissociation takes shortest time, and you see perfect three-dimensional images. And this is old photos, which was a starting point for me personally. In principle, you can make a free alpha cluster physics using such your object moves with speed of light, but internally system is not relativistic, and this is a way to for access for few body problems. Indeed, people, I come to this work only at late 90s. I joined it to this. I was appointed to be, but to this time, people made and Maria supplied me in particular made a very perfect analysis of fragmentation of neon, and it is interesting how much rich this physics and what is the meaning of these probabilities of this channel of dissociation, how this reflects internal structure of nucleus. And in principle, in cases when neon is fragmenting to 5 alpha particles, you can reconstruct invariant mass, you can subtract mass of alpha particles, and you see the scale of interaction is of the order of below 1 mega electron volt per nucleon, and it is scale of nuclear astrophysics. So it is astrophysics, nuclear astrophysics moving with speed of light, I would say. Indeed, Dubna performed a series of, I used Ikeda diagram just to transfer how they correlated, and magnesium exposures give you 6 gallium ensemble, neon 5 alpha ensemble. You can resolve relativistic beryllium 8 S-narrow pairs. You see going down oxygen going making diffractive dissociation. You see 4 alpha ensembles, and this is narrow pair of tracks is decay of beryllium 8 with energy yield of 90 kilo electron volts. So in principle, you can assume conservation of energy per nucleon, and you can reconstruct invariant mass spectra, and you do this actually. Such studies are now very much motivated to extend scenarios of many-body physics, like alpha condensation, concept of alpha condensation, for example. Source of such it was rather speculative, but we imposed a question whether we can make a coherent quantum ensemble in relativistic fragmentation. Actually, what was the beginning of our step 10 years ago, also what was done to this moment is exposures of emulsion within frame of acceleration of uranium at Berkeley, and gold in Brookhaven, and lead at CERN. And indeed, you see very interesting events, and we call them white stars because there is no black tracks, and you see a diffractive dissociation, and you produce many body many body system. Of course, this is this nuclei have some neutron excess, and you can reproduce. And that means when you see this jet of peripheral interaction, that means that inside jet you have plenty of neutrons, and you generate ensembles of neutrons. And this is a problem, I believe, especially in case of iron, for cosmic ray physicists, for such multi-fragmentation events. And even we have some contacts with people working in Pierre Auger project, and too much iron in Pierre Auger ultra-high energy spectra. Maybe multi-fragmentation is a source and not accounted in simulation program. What else? This is gold, and I said you about neutrons, but neutrons are not for emulsions. Nevertheless, we see neutron starts inside jet. So when you go along jet, you see such a secondary interaction produced by neutrons. So you produce very complicated ensemble, like this. So idea was maybe it looks like this, that you have multi-photon interaction and you have transition of system to multi-body ensemble. So in fact, this is excitation. These ideas were discussed by Lopp and Brown Munzinger, that multi-photon effects are possible. And I say this because soon I will discuss reasons why we make exposures with muons. Let me skip. So again, what I like in the paper that in such emulsions allow us to make study of multi-fragmentation reactions and internal, if you take a Boltzmann constant and temperature, internal energy scale of such system is of the order of supernova temperatures, 5, 10 to 9 kelvins. So it is interesting that we can, in fragmentation, we can make such ensembles. So, to be more practical, with our abilities of our machine, able to accelerate light nuclei, we launched this program of beam formation, as I told already, already before us, lithium-6 demonstrated itself as exotic nucleus. It has reduced mean path. Instead of running 17 centimeters in emulsion, it runs 13 centimeters. It is big, like, and as nucleus with atomic mass number 11. And in fragmentation of carbon-12, in fragmentation of primary boron-10, you can make carbon-9, carbon-10, and we perform it. Sometimes when, this subject will be more on status of the things will be presented by Denis Artemenkov, but our recent exposure was carbon-10, beryllium-7, and nitrogen-12, because ratio of Z to A is differs just less than 2 or 3%, and in magnetic channels we have both, not both, but all these nucleus, and in single exposure we separated on PhD theses, I'm proud to say that we have four PhD degrees. In Bulgaria, boron-8, Tatiana Shedrina, nitrogen-12, carbon-10 is under preparation, carbon-9 is protected, interesting, three carbon-9 going to free helium-3, beryllium-9, Denis, now you have this period somehow was rounded up because I got invitation and we make lecture notes in physics on series clusters in nuclei. And what we know about this clustering and relativistic fragmentation is published in these lecture notes. And I gathered there as many emulsion references as possible, not to be forgotten. So beryllium-9 is example, and you see in this case we statistics of beryllium dissociation was split on two groups: narrow angle groups, which correspond to beryllium beryllium 80 plus state decay, very narrow pair, and wider pairs. And it was interesting that we can reconstruct beryllium 8 in invariant mass and beryllium 2+ state, first excited states are fully reconstructed. Interesting that they have approximately the same strength, and it was for us puzzling. In fact, people working with nuclear cluster physics, they all the theoreticians working in this field, that they know well that to calculate magnetic moment of beryllium 9, they assume a two-component model, neutron plus beryllium 8, but in two with equal approximately equal probabilities as beryllium 8 0 plus and beryllium 8 2+ states. This is simply needed because otherwise shell model describes beryllium 9 magnetic moment better. And in fragmentation, we see internal structure. Same composition of a cluster wave function here. It's pleasant and finding. And so that was about, what we were doing with emulsions and still continue to do. But we have to think this emulsion was produced in Moscow, and that was the last portion of emulsion produced for FOMOS or NICFI enterprise in Moscow, all-time enterprise. Now, due to efforts, people presenting here, and they can say more on this. Slavich company in Pereslavl-Zaleski is producing a nuclear track emulsion, and we expose emulsion. This is exposure in high energy machine at Protvino, and we see we come to idea that we have to use the students not to just to make ordinary tests, but make some physical task. Because they produce emulsions, say 100 to 200 thickness emulsions, but on a glass substrate. But now we are interested. This way we are interested in application of emulsion where we can do. We are limited technically now. So to make good new physics, you have for emulsion, one have to create a new physical situation. And next physical situation, first physical idea comes that you see under we assume that multi-fragmentation of nuclear multi-fragmentation of heavy nucleus can occur under action of electromagnetic interaction, but one of probes, purely electromagnetic probes, is muons. And we come to idea to expose emulsion in high energy muons. Indeed, our friends in working in COMPASS experiment allowed us to expose emulsion to muons, and this analysis is under progress now. So CERN muon beam exists, and in principle, emulsion, what I demonstrate, was situated somewhere here, 1 meter from in muon gala. CERN intensity of CERN muon beam is 10 to 8. And we work it in intensity 10 to 6 muons per second per square centimeters. So we survive it, and I show this. Even we can do. This is exposure of emulsion. We are happy to see that we see multi-fragmentation events are induced by muons. And silver is eaten by emulsion is eaten by beam. But imagine that this plate was situated 1 meter away from beam during 3 days. 3 days. So low cross section of interaction of muons allows you to have a very good capacity for interaction. Of course, transverse irradiation, this is 9 hours of exposure. Transverse irradiation is more beneficial. We can, when we look inside, we can increase intensity factor of 100. And we can study multi-fragmentation induced by purely electromagnetic. Remember that muon is point-like particles. And you can induce, and you can make on this large volume, like 7 Fermi, you can excite nucleus, and this is due to long-range interaction of muons. So I believe that this is exposure of 100 micron thickness plates, emulsion layers. But our producer is promising us to produce soon thick emulsion, 550, without lead substrate, and suggestion is to go to muon. Muon beam in CERN will be restored in Christmas of the next year, close to Christmas of the year, and we can make a good physics task with muons. Indeed, we see very high multiplicity events, and you see up to 12 nuclear fragments, and now this analysis in progress now. We exposed four plates transversely, and three of them now Egyptian collaborators from Cairo University. Egypt is member country of institute. They decide where to what to do and where participate, and they assisted very much with purchasing of bunches of emulsion, and we provided some amount of transversely, and this is analysis is I'm proud to say now in Cairo, and we are doing ourselves, our students also doing. So. Of course, region of neutron radioactive nuclei contains all neutron-rich nuclei, and we, using Dubner capabilities, we started to think what to do with what we can do with nuclear track emulsion when we apply them at. And one is possibility can be found. Look back. It can be found in Powell textbook. Idea was that we have very nice hammers, even you can take in Photoshop. This is stops of boron 8 nucleus, beta decay, and hammers. But modern radioactive, low energy radioactive facilities produce easily beams of radioactive nuclei. And idea was to expose in Dubno, we have good gallium 8 beam, and to go with this. Another example is discovery in emulsion of carbon nucleus, very fact of existence of carbon. You see on this photograph, you see short track of carbon nucleus. This is hammer-like track. Proton decay, boron 9 is unbound nucleus. This is, and in principle, this is very nice object for digital photography, what I want to say. And exposure, say, with carbon 9 is also interesting to populate states with boron 9 and to study multibody physics. Of course, our resolution allows us, and example of gallium 8 event when we implanted emulsion is shown here. Our resolution abilities to measure ranges of particle, and this is double beta decay. In Dubno, we have a variety of low energy facilities, and one of them, Fluorov laboratory cyclotrons, and this is U400M, and this cyclotron has also supplied with a fragment separator, Aquilina. And Aquilina, in our experiment, which is published, provided us with a beam of gallium 8 of energy 7 MeV per nucleon. And we exposed emulsions in emulsion EP point, and I show you. And this will be discussed more in a report of Mamatkulov, Kahramon Mamatkulov, who made major part of analysis. So plates look like this. You see squares, and actually, enrichment of gallium 8 was 80%, and we see nuclear low energy nuclear reaction. Track is entering, and you have reaction, and also you see hammers. This is just a usual photocamera without any microscope. Emulsions. Our plate was successful. Inclination angle was 10 degrees, and one of our microscope ladies just after good vacations just destroyed plate. And interesting in this place. Interesting that low energy physics has no such strong demands. You can make photograph near destruction point. You see very perfect hammer, this one, and this is damage. So in emulsion, in this case, you in high resolution and low short tracks, you do not need very much perfectness of emulsion. What's found is a collection of hammers. We just for 10 minutes of exposure, we gathered on the plate 2,000 hammer-like tracks. Interesting what we see, and we found that our hammers, gallium 8 stops, and they are 50% of them are irregular. Why? Because gallium 8 stops and becomes atom, and gallium is noble. And it decays aside. And this is, you see, double sequential beta decay, and you can measure, make measurements, and you can study two alpha particle system. And this is interesting nuclear physics. On this place, I wish to mention that when I started to look on in literature that in CERN there is a good progress of work on a production of high-intensity source of helium-6 nuclei on proton synchrotron with beryllium oxide, and they want to obtain 10 to 15 helium. There are already in the Europhysics letters there are ideas about there are promises at least to obtain 10 to 15 helium-6 nuclei per second. For what? Because they want to obtain, they promise that multi-GeV gallium-6 can be obtained, and this is ideal source of electronic neutrino. So that is how nuclear physics, radioactive nuclei meets. And so if you imagine that you heat up emulsion to 1,500 degrees, these distances will be, of course, much larger. But gallium is not destroyed. You can do nuclear physics, like Ramon will say this, but major fact that in these hammers we perfectly, on using SRIM model, we can reconstruct ranges of alpha particles, we reconstruct position of beryllium 80 to beryllium 2 plus state, width, but we have some tail in high energy part. Interesting that this tail is due to decay energy distribution is due to most energetic, most brightest events. We cannot reject them. And distribution is not Gaussian. It is asymmetric. And two alpha particles system, I believe, it manifests itself as eight nucleonic system, complicated system with some polarization. And we can derive this knowledge. And of course, next object after this is boron-9, which is unbound. Our next attempt, and maybe this is time to attract attention of Japanese and Italian colleagues to this fact, we attempted to go to carbon-9, as I said to you. It can be serve as source of unbound boron-9 nuclei, but intensity of carbon-9, and you can imagine, just less than percent on this Akulina spectrometer. But if such exposures can be provided in, say, Riken laboratory of Japan or Katani laboratory, that would be a benefit. We can do incredible high statistic studies of decays of nuclei at rest. So this is stop point, and we cannot go this way. Too much background. You have to have this electrostatic separators and so on. Next example of and this is this program with muons. All this was started at the end of year 2011. Another example of application of nuclear track emulsion that Dubna is producing equipment for detection of explosives and narcotics special equipment, and it is based on equipment known as deuteron triton generator, which produce 10 to 7 neutron per second. And we expose it, and such equipment is standard, and it is sold and used in technology and even in mission to Mars to search for water or moon mission. We put our emulsion somewhere up of this, and we cover it 10 to 6 neutron per second, and we expose the stacks of emulsion during 1.5 hours, about 1 hour. Why? Because this energy, this is 14 MeV, is just above of threshold of free alpha system, and this is different access to alpha degrees of freedom in carbon-12. Plate look like this. You see place of triton target, this is grid of emulsion. But even in such a background condition, we used our collaboration with Department of Dosimetry of Institute of Nuclear Physics of Czech Academy of Sciences. This is Seika microscopes. And indeed, when you look in this microscope, emulsion look like boiling. This is proton recoil. Hydrogen is, emulsion is like cryogenic target. And you see a plenty of protons, and this is just recoils. And sometimes it looks like wool-like reservoir scattering. So this is emulsion is a good way to look for thermonuclear reactions of neutrons. But our goal was search for these free alpha particles, free pulse splittings. This is how carbon goes to free alpha. We can reconstruct, we can measure. Indeed, such work was done and now in publication. And our students measured 400 such stars. They were found and fully measured. And we can see energy of pairs of alpha particles. And we see this place, if you do not know, this is place for beryllium 8 2 plus state. And we have strong signal of beryllium, this hammer-like. And we have also narrow pairs of beryllium 8 0 plus. So we can make sort of calibration. Our use of ranges, range measurement and SRIM program gives us good physics picture. But besides, of course, it is interesting, and I cannot go very far to this, that our idea was about Hoyle state and so on, excitation. And our data on knockout of alpha particles maybe indicate on hidden rotation in beryllium 8 when total spin of ground state of beryllium or carbon 12 is zero, but you have superposition on counter-rotating alpha clusters. So when you make a Hoyle state is alpha Bose condensate, most important alpha Bose condensate, and it has spin zero, and ground states has spin zero. But fusion goes through first excited state. On this step, you emit photon with spin two, but somehow you have to return to spin zero again. You have to emit second photon, and you do this. But momentum conservation has to be done. And maybe such data also of interest. Neutrons. Dubna is possessing, now it is operational, is a nuclear pulsing pulsed reactor, IBR-2. And there is a very rich program on solid state physics, material science, and so on. But on this, our interest is, of course, that emulsion can return to application in neutron physics researches. And one of channels gives us possibility to use thermal neutrons. Thermal neutrons are neutrons of energy 0.3 electron volts. We expose it emulsion, but not usually our producer was friendly produced for us boron-enriched emulsion. As you know, boron 10 has great cross-section and fission, and that's another way to make calibration of ranges. So place on thermal neutrons, we just very cautious to be in beam. We see that there is darkening, stacked emulsion. In fact, we see with magnification 20, we see in boron-rich emulsion splittings of alpha lithium-7. When neutron is absorbed by boron-10 isotope, it splits, and you can measure. It's 60, 90. And such measurements are in progress, and we have about 200 handmade measurements on this. This is emulsion without boron on thermal neutrons, no splitting of boron. So again, I want to attract that it is such a rather simple object are good images for digital analysis, automated analysis. But now we make measurements, we make ranges, our idea is to reconstruct with a spectrometry. We want to make a spectrometry of boron 11, which excited states, and to check whether with this lithium 6 we are okay. And maybe last point, what was done is Dubna is has. Say practice, tradition of production of so-called nuclear filters. And Dubna has, GINR has on site a machine which produces holes in this film. And This is implantation of krypton and xenon ions on accelerator complex, and Kahraman Mamatkulov will say more on this, I believe. But what you see, that this Seiko microscope in Praga allowed us to make nice photograph of this, and you see very perfect stops of krypton ions. And energy 1.1 MeV, and you see full images. And of course, in this case, to make good analysis, some measurements are done, and I demonstrate this. That's how cyclotron looks like. This is vacuum chamber. Ranges of this stopped xenon and krypton ions is less than 20 microns, but thickness of light protecting paper is 100 microns. So this exposure was done with Вера Брадного and Кахрамон in conditions of red light, vacuum, and so on. So paper should be removed, inserted, and measurements such that, and you see this is xenon and this is krypton. You see very perfectly scattering cases, Coulomb scattering cases, and cross-section of electromagnetic, and you have to state, you can state that and energy 1 MeV per nucleon is a very good region for fission physics, and that will be discussed in my next more specific presentation. Next step, which we are going to do, is to make fission physics with uranium, with maybe with californium. But again, already on this level, we have to find collaboration with those people who possessing automatic culture of automatic analysis. Culture of automatic analysis. Otherwise, we do not benefit. Just 100 tracks for, say. And this is, indeed, we can make real nuclear physics. And idea is that to make we can make exposures, neutrons, relativistic nuclei, muons, and so on. And this allows to introduce some physics tasks for magister degrees and so on to be attractive for students. So such a comparison will be discussed in Mamatkulov report, but energy ranges, our energy of not scattered tracks is when we make calibration from SRIM, SRIM program is correspond to expectation of energy. So I believe that there is some, there could be some synergy between nuclear heavy ion physics research, fission physics, and much more romantic searches for directional searches for dark matter particles. Because first you have to have good calibration, good understanding of ultra-short tracks behavior. It is far to be trivial. When you go down, it becomes more and more complicated. And such machine, Dubno is possessing such equipment and making preparation for such for front research. We can solve on high statistics level nuclear physics, but first of all, we have to be good in calibration, in understanding, and importance of scientific tasks. So thank you very much. If I'm not very much over time. Maybe so much was said, I just concentrated work for, say, decades, months, so we can discuss this and maybe some topic seems to be. But nuclear track emulsion, I attempted to demonstrate that it is universal, rather universal technique, and you can solve fundamental, applied and fundamental problems for nuclear physics, say. Physics of nuclear molecules, three partition is fundamental problem, is not just applied. And maybe such, and they provide such tasks as abilities to raise a new generation of young emulsion experts. Maybe just.
Round.
Да нет, ну тяжело, много.
Слишком много.
Too much. Ну, я сбросил.